Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in case study 3 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. Case study 3 overview. Contoso Limited is manufacturing company that has offices worldwide. Contoso works with partner organizations to bring products to market. Contoso products are manufactured by using blueprint files that the company authors and maintains. And their existing environment is currently Contoso uses multiple type of servers for business operations including the following. They do have file server, they do have domain controller, and they do have Microsoft SQL servers. This suggests that they do have data center in their office. Your network contains an Active Directory forest named contoso.com. All servers and client computers are joined. Joined means owned by organization itself. Joined to Active Directory. You have a public facing application named F1. F1 is comprised of following three tiers. F1 is having SQL Server database, it is having web front end, and it is having processing middle tier. Each tier comprises of 5 virtual machines. This indicates that they have 5 virtual machines in front end tier, 5 virtual machines in application tier, and 5 virtual machines in database tier. Requirements: planned changes. Contoso plans to implement the following changes to the infrastructure. They want to move all their tiers of application 1 to Azure. They want to move the existing product blueprint files to Azure Blob storage. And they want to create a hybrid directory to support an upcoming Microsoft Office 365 migration project. In technical requirements, Contoso must meet the following technical requirements. First one is move all the virtual machines for F1 to Azure. Second requirement is minimize the number of open ports between F1 tiers. Third requirement is ensure that all virtual machines for F1 are protected by backups. Copy the blueprint files to Azure over the internet. Ensure that blueprint files are stored in archive storage tier. Ensure that partner access to blueprint files is secure and temporary. Prevent user passwords or hashes of passwords from being stored in Azure. Use managed standard storage for hard disks or virtual machines. Ensure that when users join devices to Azure Active Directory, the users use a mobile phone to verify their identity. Minimize administrative effort whenever possible. User requirements. Ensure that only users who are part of group named Pilot can join devices to Azure Active Directory. Designate new user named admin1 as the service admin for Azure subscription. Admin1 must receive email alerts regarding service outage. Ensure that a new user named user3 can create network objects for the Azure subscription. Question 1. You need to identify storage requirements for Contoso. Contoso requires a storage account that supports blob storage. Contoso requires a storage account that supports Azure table storage. Contoso requires a storage account that supports Azure file storage. Let's go back to requirements. Let's identify storage related requirement. Blueprint files will be stored in Azure Blob storage. Therefore, this is one of the requirement related to storage. Let's see if there is any requirement related to table storage, but we don't have any such a requirement which requires rows and columns to be saved in table storage. And let's see if we have any requirement related to file share. That also we don't see. Azure blob storage is more than enough to meet all the requirements related to storage. Therefore, to store the blueprint files, we can use blob storage, and this will be the correct answer here. And we don't have any table storage requirement, and further we don't have Azure file share requirement. Question 2, you need to move the blueprint files to Azure. What should you do? Generate an access key, map a drive, and then copy files by using file explorer. This is being used in file share, and file share is not available in our case. Use Azure Storage Explorer to copy the files. Azure Storage Explorer can be used over the internet to upload files. Therefore, it is correct answer. Use Azure Import Export service, that is to upload huge number of data using the offline method. That's why this is incorrect. Generate a shared access signature, map a drive, and then copy the files using File Explorer. Shared access signature is used for temporary access, and that is not for the purpose of uploading the data. One of the key requirement to upload the files is that it should be performed over the internet. For that, we can use Storage Explorer. Therefore, Azure Storage Explorer is the correct answer. Question 3, you need to implement a backup solution for App 1 after the application is moved to Azure environment. What should you create first? To implement the backup solution, we have to have a recovery service vault in place to store the data. Therefore, option D is the correct answer. Question 4, you need to meet the user requirement for admin 1. What should you do? Designate a new user named admin 1 as service admin. For Azure subscription, this is one of the requirements, and second requirement is receive email alerts regarding service outages. To make the user service admin, we should go to subscription blade and then select the subscription and then modify the properties of subscription to update the service admin. Therefore, option D is the correct answer. Question 5, you need to configure device settings to meet the technical requirements and the user's requirement. Which two settings should you modify? Let's look into device related technical requirements. The first device related technical requirement is to ensure that when users join devices to Azure Active Directory, the user use a mobile phone to verify their identity. Next, user requirement for device admin. User requirements related to device management is ensure that only users who are part of a group named Pilot can join devices to Azure Active Directory. So let's check in the snapshot. User may join devices to Azure Active Directory. So only selected user or group can join the devices to Active Directory. This will be the correct answer. Second setting is additional local administrator on Azure Active Directory join devices is not mentioned, so we don't have to change it. User may register their devices with Azure Active Directory is not mentioned, so we will not change it. Require multi-factor authentication to join devices, which is required because mobile authentication will be taking place. Therefore, we will change it to yes. So first option meets the user requirement, and this option meets the technical requirement. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you in next video.